you say hi?
Hi. Shortly after Violet was born, the family contacted us. They've been able to send me digital photographs. I've been able to talk to them and review the photographs with them over the phone. So it doesn't matter if you're in a different state or a different country. I can still communicate with this family. I can still get images, CT images. We can still build models. And the distance really is no longer a factor.
In this case, Violet's brain actually looks very good. The reason why you need a neurosurgeon here is not to so much deal with the brain, but the bone around the brain is fairly abnormal. And the cuts that need to be made to move the eyes together and get the nasal region closer together involve cuts that need the brain displaced slightly out of the way.
I've been able to watch her progress and her growth because we had a model built early on several months ago. We had one made just several days ago, and we can see the changes, we can see the growth, we can see the changes in the bony dimensions. And I actually feel like I know her because I've seen that model change and grow over the last several months.
Three-dimensional printing in some ways has been a natural extension of what we've done in simulation from our very beginning. It allows us now to produce exact reproductions of child anatomy that allow the surgeons at Children's within the setting of simulation to be able to do the surgery before the surgery. Dr. Meara and Dr. Proctor became kind of what we call our early adopters. It just felt so natural to them to be able to take anatomy that typically they would have to wait to get to the operating room to really get their hands on. I realized that this is going to be a real game changer.
The value of a model like this is huge. This gives me the ability actually to see on this model better than I will in the operating room. So I can see and feel the trajectory, for example, of where we will have to make certain cuts. And that's never been possible before.
When you're dealing with such a complex and unique abnormality, it's really hard to conceptualize exactly what you need to do in surgery. In Violet's case, the movement of the bones is going to be relatively complex and certainly unique. You know, no two of these cases are exactly alike. It saves a lot of the sort of thinking in the operating room. So when we get there and the patient's in front of us, we're not then using our brain power to decide what do we have to do. We really have that plan going into surgery, and that makes the whole process quicker, more efficient, and safer for the patient.
When it comes to complex cases like this, really it's the team that makes the difference. The more you practice together, the more you experience things together, the better you are at working together.
And there's a huge advantage to having the plastic surgeon and the neurosurgeon because there's aspects of the case neither one of us would take on individually. It would just be far too complex. And the other components of the team, such as the anesthesiologist and the nursing team and the simulation program, are all key to getting a good outcome. And then it's the postoperative care, the ability to go to an ICU where I know, boy, we've got some of the top intensivists really looking after this child who may be somewhat sick after such a large procedure. In centers where they don't have as collaborative a team approach, it would be really hard to take on these very difficult cases.